What?
Yeah, if you're looking for a paintbrush to paint miniature models, you should definitely check out watercolour brushes. Okay, bear with me. So if you're looking for a high quality brush that is not going to cost the earth, but still give you the best results you can possibly get, then yes, you should definitely be checking out watercolour brushes. Now, I know it sounds weird, but just bear with me. Now, all the main model manufacturers, doesn't matter if it is tabletop miniatures or scale models or whatever, all the main manufacturers have their own line of paintbrushes. Now, of course, there's nothing wrong with that, especially if it creates a one-stop shop to help new modelers and painters coming into the hobby. And that can only be a good thing. The challenge is that people see that design for painting models strapline, and then they then buy it as they believe that's the best tool for the job. But often in the description, it's just listed as a detail brush, and it doesn't even tell you what it's made of. So therefore, you have no idea if it's a good price for what it is, or the level of quality, or even if it's the right tool for the job you're trying to do. As one tabletop miniature brand I was looking at recently, they had brushes on there for about £20 for one brush. And that's not even including post and packaging. So you buy a few of these, it's gonna ramp up pretty quickly. Now the next challenge is outside of the world of the model manufacturer brands, you're then getting into the world of artist brushes. And there is thousands of different types of brushes, all made of different types of things, all to do different jobs. So when you start looking at all these artist brushes, you end up searching late into the night and just ending up completely lost and confused. Now in the past, I know I have, so if you've experienced this or want to learn more about these brushes and where you can find them, then please let me know down in the comments. So maybe it's time to broaden your brush horizons. Now, one thing to remember is there is not one brush to rule them all. So whether it be synthetic or natural hair bristles or fine hair bristles, they're all designed to do different jobs. So when it comes to brushes that are ideal for painting miniature models, especially if you're using acrylic paints, then often you'll hear people say the top of the line is going to be a sable brush. Now also please remember that not all sable brushes are created equal, but it's generally accepted that the finest of these come from the very tips of the tail of the Kolinsky sable, and these are very unimaginatively known as Kolinsky sable brushes. Now when you're looking at these brushes, just be aware of the language used in the marketing. So for example, it may just say sable, or it could say the finest red sable. Now, red sable is very, very good, and it is usually cheaper than Kolinsky sable. But the Kolinsky sable tends to have more snap and more spring in the bristles than the red sable does. Now, both of them will hold the same amount of pigment, it will hold the same amount of liquid, but the red sable tends to wear out and wear down a lot quicker than the Kolinsky sable. So therefore, you're getting more bang for your buck if you buy the Kolinsky, even though it's more expensive. Anyway, backing away from that slight tangent, so if you go digging on the artist brush manufacturers' websites, you'll find that the Kolinsky sable brushes are in the watercolour section. Why? Well, primarily because they're made for watercolours. Now this is because the hair tapers down to the very finest point, and also it holds the most liquid and the most pigment, and it wears well. So this makes it ideal for really delicate work. Now for all these reasons, it makes them ideal when it comes to doing detail work on your miniature models. And not only is this bristle type awesome for watercolours, it's absolutely amazing for acrylics as well, and you can even use them for detail work with oils. But just make sure you give it a little bit extra clean out afterwards. And now this is the crazy bit. Also remember that a brush is a very personal tool, and it's down to what suits you best and the style and the way you paint. Now it's no secret that I'm a fan of the Rosemary & Co brushes. You'll have seen me using them for ages. So for example, my number zero, the Kolinsky Sable brush from the series 33 from Rosemary & Co, and this has been my workhorse for best part of a year now, and it has stood to everything I've thrown at it, including a very unfortunate incident where my dog was very unwell and therefore a scented candle was needed whilst I was painting, and like a fool put it down next to my water brush cup. And yeah, it took a little bit of TLC, but it even survived that. Now just the record, I'm not being sponsored and I'm not being paid to say this, but I love these brushes. Not just because they are a joy to use, but also because it's a small family-based company here in the UK, and you can get through and talk to a real person really easily if you have any issues or if you want any advice. But put all that to one side for a minute. This is the absolute bit that kind of blew my mind. Now, do you remember that sable brush we talked about earlier on? That's about £20. So let's kind of have a look at that number zero from series 33. Now obviously these prices are correct at time of filming, but yeah, it's good, isn't it? If you want to spread your wings into the world of artist brushes and you want to take a look for yourself, to make life simple, I'll put a link down in the description which will take you directly to the series 33 range. And of course, whilst you're there, have a look around and see what else you can find. And I would love to hear from you down in the comments, A, what catches your eye, but also what you could use it for, or want to learn more about these brushes and where you can find them, then please let me know down in the comments. If you liked that, if you found that useful, please bash that like button and share it across your social media. And I'll see you for the next project.